This podcast is brought to you and powered by Sunday Cool Tees. Watch this or listen.
Whoa.
Dang. And that's why he's the boss.
Nailed it.
I was always confused of like, why is he the boss? And like, and then just then it's like, well, that's why he's the boss.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why he's Danny.
And that's Danny.
And that's Danny boy.
Well, you're probably wondering why we're out in the middle of the parking lot tanning here at Sunday Cool, huh?
It's because we got a brand new color of shirt. It's called tan.
Heather tan. It's our new Sunday Cool super soft tee, along with the new color.
Heather sage. It's pretty neat.
Heather sage. Pretty neat.
You should go to SundayCool.com. Order custom merch for all your friends, your groups, even your, you know, own business, eh?
Hey, I see. I think, yeah.
Could have said it better myself there, Josh.
SundayCool.com. Go now.
Toodles.
Hey guys, we forgot to mention, if you go to SundayCoolSwag.com, you can get this design right now for yourself. It's beautiful. Look at that. Everything rhymes with orange. Sunday Cool merch. Go. SundayCoolSwag.com. Bye. Back to the show. Andrew, please. We have to edit this. We have to get done. Come on.
We're here. Orange Conference 2024, Atlanta, Georgia. Here we are. At the Airbnb. What do you think, Lil?
It's great. It's great.
Lily.
You're not my wife.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry to say this, Josh, but Lily's kind of attractive today.
Hey.
I'm talking about Danny. Look at that mustache.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Look at this guy.
Georgia looks good on you, Lily.
Does court.
It's the weirdest.
Does your wife like your mustache?
We're going to need a minute. What?
Does Courtney like your mustache?
She does.
Yeah?
She does, yeah.
Interesting.
I've threatened to kind of like shave it a couple of times. She's like, no, don't shave it. I'm like, oh.
Okay.
Like kind of testing the waters. Like, ah.
All right. Okay. All right, after that. Yeah, we'll keep it.
That's how Danny talks when he's like all confident.
Okay.
Anytime he gets a compliment, he's like,
you really think so? You really think I'm great? Okay. Okay.
Yeah, it's...
And anytime he gets criticism, it's just, yeah, I mean, that's fine. That's great. That's just gets the complete opposite. How you doing, Josh?
Josh, how's it going?
Josh socialized the amount that...
Dude, his quota...
For a lifetime.
Yeah,
today.
His quota for the entire spring.
Is yeah, for real.
It's done.
We hung out with hundreds of people today.
And yeah. It was dope. They're dope people.
No, but, I mean, like, yeah, it was great. An absolute blast, but we're exhausted from it. And especially you.
Yep.
It's 11 o'clock at night.
Yes, it is.
Is it really?
But you know what?
Almost.
But we do it for the fans.
But we do it for the fans.
We're doing it for you.
Yep. Hey, everyone.
They're like,
let's go.
Shark Bay, hoo ha.
That was more like Betty White in The Proposal.
Mm. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
What? Dude, The Proposal. Courtney loves that movie.
It's okay. It's okay. It's fine. Sandra Bullock, peak Ryan Reynolds.
Peak cinema,
Bullock?
Dude.
Bullock?
Peak cinema.
I don't...
Honestly, probably the greatest movie that's ever graced the silver screen.
I don't know, dude.
Dare I say.
Blindside.
That's a sham, though.
Hey, guys, but sponsor, First Form.
First Form.
And we're totally drinking these 200 milligrams of caffeine at 11 o'clock at night because it's that good.
I will say I chugged one of these earlier, and it got me all the way to today.
He's actually drinking it.
Yeah, because he needs it.
I will not be drinking this
because I'm 100 years old.
I do not want to stay up till
because it works
3 days from now.
Yeah, but it could be worth it though.
All right, you're right.
That's true. Oh man.
All right, do your best can opening sound because that was terrible.
It's not bad.
That was pretty good.
Pretty good, Josh.
I'm kind of mad at myself.
I got a talent.
I'll leave.
Yeah. It's more.
Yeet! That's weird.
Oh, man. I'm not comfortable.
Here we are.
But
here we are.
With Danny, this is your third podcast.
Number three, baby.
You're a veteran now.
Yeah. Is there a club like SNL?
Yeah, you got a jacket.
Yay.
It's in the mail.
Yeah.
We'll get it. Right. Super soft tees. We'll print it for you.
Oh, okay.
Sunday cool that can't.
A veteran jacket. Hold on.
A green jacket.
I just need a second. Let me take a power nap.
All right.
Okay.
Quiet.
Mm-hmm.
Quiet.
I just fell asleep.
we just wait for the bit. I'm just like, shh, it's gonna be worth it, please.
We should say everyone is very tired right now.
Yeah, yeah.
This has been a long day.
Not me. I'm never tired.
Good job.
Never tired. Look at me.
So we'll
I'm never tired.
Acting.
No, it's great to be back. I mean, Dusty Slay hasn't been on the podcast 3 times.
That's true.
Yeah, you just keep telling yourself that. You just keep telling yourself that. Whatever makes you feel better. Danny sat down. He's like, wait, is this the camera that Dusty used?
Yeah, I know. It's pretty cool. This camera's great.
We're having a good time.
All right. Yeah. Whatever you said, I love Dusty.
Hey, that was pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah. One more time?
I can't do it twice.
Don't tell me to do it twice.
That's weird.
All right.
Danny, do you want a song?
Danny, do you want a song?
Of course, guys.
Okay, let's do a song. All right,
you got to hear my mic stand because that thing would not reach.
Okay, here we go. I got you. Stuck in your feet.
Yo, Andrew's got his toes out.
Ooh. You got them dogs out.
They bite.
My arm's going to get super tired.
All right, we ready?
Feel free to rest on my thigh.
Just thigh.
Here we go.
Here we go. Danny.
Whoa.
Sweet Danny. Oh, we love you.
Oh, we love you.
Just an old sweet boss. Keeps on running through my mind.
Through my mind.
I said, oh, Danny. Sweet Danny.
Sweet Danny.
A love so true.
Love so true.
So welcome back. Two ninjas are butterflies.
Ninjas are butterflies.
I said I got it!
No, Danny!
Oh. Danny!
Danny!
Roll Dance is here with us.
Oh.
Episode 88, y'all. Welcome back to Ninjas and Butterflies. NPR. Here we are.
I say, oh, Danny.
Come back. I said, oh, damn. Just every time.
An hour and a half. I said, Danny.
Every time someone recommends Ninjas and Butterflies, this is the episode they listen to. Like, no, I promise you, they were good before that. I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened this episode.
Oh,
thanks, guys.
Hey, yeah. Welcome back, Danny.
Andy, there was a moment where you went fully confident and just sent it. Yeah, and it was actually on, dude.
It was really good.
You were on.
I was floating above myself, watching myself. I said, wow, are you Ray Charles right now?
I said, hold on.
Are you Ray Charles?
Your G minor pentatonic was on point.
I'm just thinking of all the people that are trying to sleep right now in this house.
Yeah.
We're just screaming.
I know that should make me want to be more quiet, but for some reason that's making me want to just
go the opposite way.
Tennessee. Remember Tennessee?
Absolutely. Yep. But you remember as a kid, like every time you stayed up late, you had to be quiet.
Yeah.
But
now
we're as adults, we get to be loud.
We go,
I like that.
Dude, the Tennessee episode, there are so many times. Like I would say close to weekly that I think about when he said the China Wall.
You know about the China Wall?
Yeah,
that's
same.
One of the funniest memories that I think I have in my life.
So the China Wall.
Yeah.
You mean the Great Wall of China?
Great Wall of China?
Yeah, the China Wall.
Seems like I'm just being efficient with my words, guys. I'm using less words. Why say less word? Why say more word when less word do trick? Kevin
Why
Malone.
Say less word when more word do trick?
Tell me this.
Seriously.
Why?
Great memory.
Yeah.
Oh.
Good times.
We're having a good time, but unfortunately, we have a really bad time right now.
What's going on, Josh?
You okay?
No.
You seemed fine before this. I don't understand.
I know. But
man.
Okay. Breathe through it, bud. You're all right. What was that? You okay?
We have a question. And today's question is, well, it's something.
Seems like it's really weighing heavy on you, man.
Yeah.
Jeez.
I mean, I don't know, guys. We do this every week, and I just think, like, why? You know, it becomes so heavy at times, and
yeah, it's a lot of weight, man. Like, don't beat yourself up.
Yeah, I know.
Just let it out, man.
This question's deep today. Yeah. Today's question, sent in by a viewer.
It's okay, man. Don't cry.
Yeah.
I can tell you're emotionally vested in
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Shut up. Stop. Today's question sent in by a viewer.
What are you doing? What are you doing right
stop,
now?
Stop, stop.
Scared.
Does the president deserve what's coming?
Oh, shoot, man.
Whoa.
Does the president deserve what is coming? Danny.
Yes.
Whoa.
Whoa. What was that, dude? Why would you say yes? Can you expand on your answer? Because I would really like to know your thought process. Yeah, I don't understand why you would have that kind of opinion.
Well, I mean,
I figured that was kind of like an open shut question.
Yeah.
I just think, you know, election year. It's an election year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The incumbent is always kind of on the hook to, like, okay, you got to solidify.
Incumbent's not a word, but keep going.
Yeah.
To the American people of, like, why you deserve this office in the first place.
Yeah.
You know, an onslaught of, you know, questions around his ability to do this, his, you know, all of that. I think he deserves the questions that are coming his way. That's kind of where I'm at right now.
I mean, I'm not sure I completely agree with that.
No, Danny. I mean, so it seems like, Danny, if I'm getting this right, it seems like you're saying the questions that are coming towards him, that he deserves to be accountable for them?
Josh, I think what you're trying to say is that Danny thinks whatever is coming to him is questions, but in reality, it's a lot of judgment and it's a lot of hatred.
In reality, what we were saying was...
Does the president deserve what is coming to him? And absolutely he does not.
What's deserving of what is to come, Danny, with what we're trying to say, is grace and peace.
Love and eternal forgiveness.
Yeah, if we can't expect him to receive that, how are we supposed to live in a society that
so, guys, if I'm getting this right.
Yeah. And I hope you are.
And I think I am.
Yeah, I believe it.
Danny only wants to pass judgment and not extend
grace. Yes.
And
I believe he's thinking the hard questions should come. But in reality, when grace and love is offered, he thinks the president should be rejected.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was going to say.
And I don't think that's ever the case.
I don't think so either.
So Danny hates our president?
Whoa. Oh, wow. Well, you heard it here first. Danny is our president.
Oh, no.
What? This is weird. Welcome to the show.
All right, thanks, guys. See you later.
The butterfly is no doubt one of God's most
beautiful. Has it empty your mind?
You were martial arts!
Ha! Ninjas are dead!
J just like we rehearsed.
All right.
Hang on one second. Everybody's like settled into like different seats.
Oh, man.
Positions.
I haven't. Because I'm perfect. Don't you start taking
toddler.
See, explain, Josh, what are your why are you taking a picture of me right now?
Okay.
What are you creating? What?
Nothing. I got it.
Is it the toddler thing?
Yeah. Josh is starting to take photos of me because he thinks I look like a toddler. And I don't think the photo evidence proves otherwise. I think it's just a 30-year-old man comfortable in his own body. Maybe. Maybe that's it.
The one on the truck though.
You're missing context.
So I started an album.
You're missing context.
It's called Andy Toddler. And
baloney.
Here's the first picture.
Why are we amusing this? Amusing. Why am I entertaining this? I'm out of my mind right now.
Why are we amusing this?
Shut up. Entertaining this whole idea.
It's amusing.
And then we have this one.
No, that was just long road trip trying to be comfortable.
Classic iPad kid.
And then we have this one where it looks like I sat you on the counter when you woke up from a nap.
Okay, that one's a tough one. That's a tough one to defend. But I was just, trying to hang out with my buds. Everyone was in the kitchen. There was no seats. So
all three of my daughters have sat in that exact same position first thing in the morning.
Back straight.
It didn't help that you, just before that, you were giving me a bath in the sink. Like with the washcloth and stuff.
Oh.
The reason why I was on the counter is because I was patiently waiting for you to cut off the crust on my PBJ. But that's the only reason.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, man. Sorry, guys. This is a wild ride.
Yep. Hey, actually, and they're here for it.
I'm not sorry.
You know what? Let me take that back.
You know, I'm not sorry. Because we're tired.
You deserve this.
Jeez, that
you deserve
like,
low
energy. You're looking at your camera. Yeah, you deserve that.
And he was there. Is there a ghost?
That pizza was great.
Yeah.
I was tanking.
Shout out Mello.
Shout out Mello.
Please, Mello Mushroom, please sponsor us.
That would be a cool
one. Deliver a pizza every pod.
Also, last night, dinner was great too. Hawkers. Mm. We could do that as well. Yeah. Shout out to waiters, waitresses. They bring a lot to the table.
Dude, you know what? Shout out to waiters and waitresses right now.
Hey.
I mean, like, they don't get enough credit.
Yeah.
Did you hear that?
I did. I got that joke? I got that. Flew over their heads.
I said they bring a lot to the table and you guys didn't laugh.
Okay, well, you said that after you, because you're trying to save your butt, because that was a weird thing to say. Just thanking the whole world for waiters and waitresses. Like, you know, can we just pause this whole podcast?
You wouldn't have to fill the space if you would fill it.
Okay, well, is that a fat joke? Because I feel like...
Talk about something
you're making a joke. Would you just go? We're talking.
30 seconds.
You don't have to say anything. Just walk away. We're talking. You haven't said anything in a minute.
Where are you going?
No, I wouldn't have.
Andy, what's a band that you love that most people hate?
Oh,
I know that's
man.
Like a hard question.
Nickelback, I guess. I don't know. That's the easy answer.
Favorite song by Nickelback.
Oh, man. How is what is that? Oh, man. What is it? What's that one song? Nope.
This is how
go
you
the bathroom.
Remind me.
No, this is it's a sad. It's a love song.
That,
I don't know which one it
that
is.
That Deadpool
though.
Skit. Was top notch with that song.
Oh yeah, with Fred Savage. That was great. Did you see that?
I didn't see that.
Dude. Oh, it's awesome.
Deadpool defends Nickelback and they sing a song together.
Oh, well, it's making fun of Princess Bride.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
How the grandpa came and saying read the book to Fred Savage.
Yeah.
But it's Fred Savage as an adult and Deadpool's the grandpa. And he's talking about and they just like rant about how Nickelback is actually one of the greatest artists of all time because of all their records and all the things
That's
they've
great.
Sold in one.
We were talking about the Beatles today.
Yeah, Beatles are overrated.
I think that was like its own genre and time, and it's like I think everybody thought it was really good because it was so different, but ultimately it was like it was not that good.
It is crazy how much they were like people went nuts for the.
Are
Beatles.
We actually
crazy.
All in agreement that Beatles is mid?
I don't think it's mid, but I just think it's like to say that they're the great like one of the greatest bands of all time. I don't think they're in the top five of greatest bands of all time.
It just was so different for its time. That's why it was like it was a just shock factor of like, what is happening right now?
But it's but if they came out today, would they hold up?
No, because they brought in rock.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So there's a cultural significance that like, but as far as musical stuff, musical standalone, if you had no context of their upbringing, of the radical movement that they brought across the British in the US, I don't think you would know. I don't think it would be as big.
Yeah, today, of course not.
Yeah, but I'm saying, so based on their music alone,
that's
they're overrated. Dude,
that's not a fair argument.
I agree.
I think it's fair. Let us know in the comments.
You can't say that about anyone now.
No.
Anyone that's like, wow, they're like, what they're doing is like really.
I mean, if you're unique innovative. Enough, you're going to succeed in every generation.
They were.
Nah, that's not true, though.
I'm saying if you drop their music in today without, like,
they're
in
still
today's
like
culture.
One of the most popular bands.
Okay. That's your opinion?
Josh, do you love the Beatles?
Yes.
he's defending the Beatles like.
I am, because you're defending Nickelback.
He asked me what's one hot band take. That a lot of people don't like, hot and I said take. Nickelback.
Hot take. You defended is Nickelback. Better than the Beatles.
Whoa.
Whoa.
That's what Andy said.
Mm. I actually would never say that.
Okay. That's interesting.
Now we're getting somewhere.
What are you talking about? I didn't bring up the Beatles.
Who brought it up?
Not me.
I said we were talking about it today. We were talking about bands or something today. The Beatles. I didn't know this was such a hot jeez.
Dude, this camera is racist and it's made in an Asian country, but it thinks my knee is my face. And it keeps focusing on my knee.
I mean, I can't you
knee how
I honestly
very good.
Very good. Very good. Excellent.
That was stellar.
Stellar.
That was Mandarin.
I doubt it.
Yeah,
you mean Chinese.
You calling me orange?
No.
Orange chicken?
It's okay.
Can we start calling Andrew orange chicken?
I'm here for it.
You heard it here.
Can we start calling him General?
Oh, yeah. General.
Yeah.
And how do you say that?
Sal? So?
I heard Tao.
Tao?
But the people that say Tsao is definitely wrong.
Dude, I was
we all can agree that's definitely wrong.
So I formed like a relationship with a Chinese takeout place in my hometown. Great place. Shout out Tokyo Express. Someone figure that out for me.
I've had it. I've had food poisoning there. Keep going.
Okay. Yeah. Well, Tokyo Express, you know, Tokyo, Japan, Chinese restaurant. Anyways, I actually asked them. I was like, how do you say this? And I'm not even going to try. But we went back and forth a few times where they said it. And I said it back, and they corrected me, and I swear it was exactly what I said, but they did it enough times for me to not ever be confident.
Tiao.
Yeah.
General Tiao.
I just say general, what's, and I let them finish.
When you say you formed a relationship with them, was it you just got to know the people there, or you like ate their
if there was someone in the line in front of me, I would. No, I literally called the place one time and I didn't get to read my order and they were like, orange chicken, mushroom chicken. And I was like, I can do it.
Whoa. Okay. Yeah, you can, I guess.
And I was like, that's my order. And they're like, okay, 15 minute.
It's like Cheers, like where everybody knows your name.
It was a place I got burgers in my hometown too. They knew my name as well. Shout out to their staff. They're rad people.
What a guy.
Yeah, congratulations to all the restaurants that can memorize a name. Golly. I'm trying to sell you something, Andrew. That's all it was. You fell into that trap.
Nah, dude. They gave me free boiled peanuts and a beat of root beer.
That's true. That's actually a sign of... That's actually Andrew's love language.
Josh, what are we doing?
And boiled peanuts.
What
are we doing? Let's go.
Okay.
Help.
What do you want to talk about? We can we can talk about aliens.
Well, just over there pulling a lily.
Why do orangutans' noses look like buttholes?
Bud.
It's weird.
I have a lot of notes.
It's weird.
It does, dude. Why do you have Candy Crush open? Can we add like little Candy Crush sound effects? I got the candy cane crown. Yes.
The Tucker Carlson interview with Joe Rogan.
Dude, what a wild episode. It was almost 3 hours, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wild.
It was really dope. And
within 8 minutes, they're already talking about demons and evil and good and like spiritual attacks and stuff.
Yeah.
That was bonkers.
So our goal is to have Tucker on.
Come on, Tuck.
To, because he's talked to very high ranked people with the whole alien disclosure or UFO disclosure.
I mean, he's worked so closely with so many people in the government that are high up. Like, no matter what side of the aisle you're on, like, it's an interesting conversation. Like, yeah. that's a crazy interesting, like, life that he's lived. I mean, the experience he has is nuts.
I learned a lot from it, too. With, like, he talked about Richard Nixon a lot.
Yeah, tell us about that. That was kind of wild.
Yeah, well, he's just like, there's never going to be a president to where they cannot be controlled, basically. That's basically what he was saying. Mm-hmm. And Nixon was, like, so outside the realm of the CIA and stuff and, like, willing to disclose a lot of stuff that the CIA was trying to keep under wraps. And so he basically alluded to the CIA planted, not they forced the hand of, like, the Watergate scandal.
Yeah.
And, like, what do you say? It was like, how many people, like, raided the Watergate building or something?
Like, three or four people or something like that.
And he said three out of the four people that raided Watergate were CIA agents.
Jeez, dude.
And so it's like,
yeah.
God. I mean, that's kind of like writings on the wall.
I don't know. It makes you think. Do you hear how they got caught that night in the hotel?
It was a janitor, right?
It was a piece of duct tape. They put it on the door to make sure it wouldn't lock on themselves. And it was poking out, and he was walking by, and he saw it, and he reported it. And that's all it took, was literally just a piece of duct. You talk about, like, the tiny little decisions we make or something that affect everything?
Yeah.
Nutso.
Wow.
But, I mean, if it was an inside job or something like that, you know. And he obviously admitted, like, he's like, I remember, that was that Frost-Nixon interview where he said, well, if the president does it, it's not illegal. It's like,
yeah.
Well.
Yeah.
Yikes. I mean, that's probably a lot of the government's thinking, but, you know. Hey, that's my thought whenever I see that yellow light.
Hey. Hey. It was yellow, officer.
Your Honor, I didn't see the kids. I'm sorry.
But we were talking today, though, because you were saying that Nixon had the largest, like, popular vote.
Yeah, in U.S. history.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what Tucker said. He had the, even today, he had the most popular vote in U.S. history. And, like,
that's crazy.
Yeah.
I didn't know he was that popular. But,
like, I'm just thinking, like growing up, like, everything I heard about Nixon, like, I viewed him as, like, a really bad guy.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, whole I'm not a crook. Like he was thrown under, like, yeah, raked over the coals. I don't know much about him. I'm dumb politically wise, but, like, that was definitely the stigma the whole time. Like, he was a bad president.
Yeah,
because
in reality, it's just like what he did, the whole Watergate thing, it was a wiretapping thing, right?
Yeah.
Like listening in on a conversation.
Yeah.
Like, look at what we have now.
I know, man.
Like, we have the, it's called the Patriot Act that was passed after 9/11, where they're now tapped into, they can listen to any of our conversations.
Yeah.
Or texts, all that stuff.
I mean, what makes it different? We think about, like, with China, how they have all those, like, facial recognition cameras that are on every street corner. Not even every street corner. Even more than that. Like, they're everywhere. And we think, wow, that's such a crazy world, dystopian world to live in. But it's like, what are we holding on to?
Well,
you know, or like, the Alexas have been proven to have listened. Like, phones are obviously listening. Like, it's like, it just feels weird. It's like almost like a out of sight, out of mind kind of thing. It's like, we're not, like, that bad because we're not in your face about it.
You guys see Apple get in trouble too because their incognito mode, apparently they were logging all of that info too and, like, selling, like, website searches and stuff.
I mean, why wouldn't they?
Yeah.
I mean, anything, there's no privacy anymore. And that's what Tucker talked about, like, about privacy. Like, it's like, it should be a right. Like, it should be something that we are allowed to, but they're like, no, we're not. But it's just the illusion of it.
Yeah. And New York is about to pass a thing for security cameras all throughout New York City.
What about it?
And it's AI driven. And it's supposed to detect when someone pulls out a gun.
Mm.
But it's like, is that like a...
Well, what? Hold on.
Yeah, I don't know.
How are you going to respond? Like, he's got a gun.
What?
Like, I mean, there's obviously an alert or something. Yeah, like, they imagine they'd have, like, some type of system.
The damage is flipping done by the time.
I know, but they respond quicker, right? But like, is that like an avenue to, like,
anything,
introduce AI into our security system to where it's just like...
That's what
that's China's
scary.
Doing right now.
Potentially,
with the AI and their...
Yeah.
Like... Yeah, all that stuff.
Do you hear, not to change subjects a ton, but do you hear what Sam Altman, right? AI guy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do you hear what Sam Altman had his whole idea for how he can get his money, the whole idea about how he can get his investors' money back?
No.
He's at a conference. It's on video. He's literally on stage. And the plan for him getting all the investors' money back is they're going to create this AI system. They're going to build it the way they foresee it, like everything like that, all according to plan. And then they're going to ask it, how can we get this money back to our investors? And we will rely on that.
To the AI?
He says it all on. I was like, that can't be real. But it's like he's literally saying it. It's like this is the plan. Like that's the that's how much faith we have in this whole thing. It's like that's what's going to save us. It's going to give us the answer. It's going to show us the plan. I'm like, that seems like you're giving it the ultimate control.
I'm sitting
like
here.
We're in debt to this AI now.
I'm sitting here judging that, but the reality is if I was like playing around with some sort of AI program, ChatGPT or whatever, and then it dawned on me that I could ask it how to give me money, I would fully utilize that.
Yeah, but it's not going to just print you money. Like you have to do things. Like it's just like you're relying on more intelligence instead of just like how to run a company instead of just your own and your own leadership and like understanding the world. Like you're like, all right, now tell us, what can we do?
Yeah.
Like that doesn't make sense.
But I think like the ChatGPT like language models and those types of things that are happening right now, I do think there is a level at which it's making us lazy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And I think the lazier that it makes us, the more we're lulled to sleep in terms of like what's like really bad things can happen.
And as an investor, you're sitting in the crowd like, can I have my money back?
Yeah.
Actually, can we not do this whole thing? I want a refund.
Yeah. Can I get a
refund? Yeah, please. Sam, please.
I don't know. The AI stuff is just, it's so weird to me, man.
Yeah, and it's just taken off. Like, it's nutso. And it's just so hard because, like, it was like, we saw signs of it. Like, there was movies about it in the 80s. There was movies, like, Age of Ultron was all centered around.
Yeah.
And it's, I don't know, man. There's just so many things. That's the tough thing. It's like when we talk, listen to that comedian today about, like, the aliens. And like true crime, it's like we're so stimulated, we don't know what to be scared of anymore. It's like AI, seriously. Aliens, political stuff, you know, true crime. Like we're just gonna exist at this point.
You said some the other day in the office where we were talking about the moon landing, and I thought it was a very fascinating thing what you said. So basically, when they talk about going to the moon again, there's an interview with NASA, and the guy said, well, we've lost the technology, or we've lost the knowledge, or the
we lost technology. Yeah,
and so like it's like we're trying to rebuild it to where we can go back.
And we ask ourselves like, how is that possible? Like, yeah, why
it was the 60s, right? And like we're like at like a pinnacle now with technology. So how do you lose it? And Andy said, he's like, if we're talking about, it was from the Blurry podcast of like. These fallen angels and stuff, like giving us information and ways to make things, right? So, like, can they take that back?
If they can give information, is it possible that they can take that information from us?
So, was the information given to go to the moon?
And then take it back.
And then, like, okay, now we're taking it back because they maybe were trying to take control of it.
I mean, who knows? But it's like one of those things where like it would be easy for the government to like say, I mean, this is such a crazy thing.
It's
wild. It was just a question. Like I was like,
I loved it though.
But like, if you give something, you have the ability to take it back. And so when we look at like the whole government, like it would be easy for them to say we lost the technology because they're telling the truth and everyone could question that. But it's like, you can't come in here and audit us and even find the technology. Because we literally don't have it anymore.
Yeah.
So it's like, almost like a scot-free answer.
Well, it would make sense of like, if we talk about like the ancient civilizations of like how like technologically advanced they were with like the pyramids and like stuff like, oh, we don't even know how they made the pyramids. Like, like how long it would have taken, like the methods they use. And like, so that's a lost insight of like how they did this thing. Right.
Yeah.
So like the moon, going to the moon, was this like a process of like we were given this information to do whatever with, and then it was like taken away.
Yeah.
Or even if it was like some sort of energy or resource,
you know, like some type of fuel, something that was necessary to make that venture. And if that resource was withdrawn, you know, like we, even if we still had the tech to do it, it's like, but we need this thing to power everything or to break through different atmospheres, whatever it may be, you know?
Yeah.
It would just make sense that that
basically we're getting way too far deep into this stuff. And we're, this is our mindsets constantly.
Yeah. But they're making a movie about it. Did you see that?
Yeah. Yeah.
They're making a movie about how the little government and NASA conspired to fake the moon landing. And it's like big stars. Wow. And it's like, yeah, okay. We make fantasy films, but it's like, is this just not one of the things that they just like, you have to be out in the open about it. Yeah.
So NASA hired it. It was like a marketing director, right? So like it was it was with Scarlett Johansson.
Okay, yeah.
And the whole point was like the movie plot is like no one was getting behind going to the moon. So they hired a marketing director to come in. Hey,
it's you, Danny.
That's you. Wait a second.
Wait, if Scarlett Johansson's there and Danny's right there, then who's that?
And if she was involved in the fake moon landing, who the heck are you?
Man, it's getting late, guys. I gotta...
No, but the whole idea, like, there, it was just like, how can we convince them? And so, like, they even alluded to, like, Neil Armstrong was an actor, was not an astronaut. And so it's crazy. Like, he's like, we can get to the moon, but, like, we can't film it.
Sure.
And so she's like, okay, then we'll film it on a stage.
Yeah, think about that. Like, it takes a smart person to get to the moon to be an astronaut. Smart people are nerds. Nerds look dorky. He doesn't look like a dorky nerd.
No, he's a war vet. He's a handsome war vet.
Yeah.
Hey, suspect. I don't trust anyone who was attractive at any point in their life.
Also, it took us an hour to set up this, to film this. Imagine what it would take to set up to film on the moon.
Seriously.
It's just wild. The live streaming is what's really crazy to me. It's right. Like, because I lose signal when I go into an elevator. What are we talking about?
Yeah, right.
Like, can we just be honest for a second? There's in 1969, that's just not possible.
And with
right?
the phone call, yeah. I mean,
live
it's
TV.
So hard. Yeah. To believe.
Everybody always talks about like less computing power to get to the moon than what's in our iPhones. Now it's like, okay, well, how did we do all that, but we can't figure out how to get back to the moon now? It doesn't make sense.
And would it feel any, like, would we be any better off if the government literally just came out and said, okay, yes, we went to the moon, but we didn't go when we said we did. This is fake. And, like, was completely, but then I feel like at that point, everyone would be like, okay, so now we can't trust you at all.
Yeah.
But it's like, right. So you can't even, like, they can't even be honest just a little bit. Even if it was like, listen, you have to understand, in war times, we're trying to create something. The country needed this.
Yeah.
Like, I would do, you know, as a president, you're probably like, I would do anything to give my country a leg up, to get them going and get them excited about this.
But it did. I mean, it dismantled the USSR at that time.
So that's the thing. Like, so it's like, is it worth it? Like if we knew, like, okay, you know, I get it. You know, is it justified? But it's like, you can't, if you ever came forward with that information, know, then
just
you're throwing trust
point,
out the window.
You just kind of be like, all right, guys. Yeah, we faked it.
Hey, can I be real for you a second, pal?
We don't even think the moon's real. We think it's a hologram.
You guys.
We've never been there.
Wait, you guys still believe in the moon?
Hold on a second.
We never talked about when we talked about the eclipse the last episode.
Uh-huh.
I got on this deep rabbit hole of like the eclipse stuff.
Okay. All right.
And apparently, there's a large majority of people that think when the eclipse happen, they replace our sun with an artificial sun.
Change of the light bulbs.
Golly, man.
And I was watching. I'm just like, what? I'm like, I kept on scrolling past this stuff. I'm like, okay, you guys are, you're being psycho at this point.
Yeah.
But I mean, dude, it was like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm like. And then, like, your the algorithm. Fifth one, I'm just like, I watched the whole thing.
Josh's
I'm like, this
algorithm is
I said,
just so...
I said, hold on. I'm watching. I'm like, man, I don't know. I saved it, but then I was leaving work and I walk outside and it looked different.
Guys, it just looked different.
Listen, I walk outside and just like everything, like the light looked different. It was like weirdly lit. I'm like, what in the world? And I look at the sun. I'm like,
are you real?
hold on a second. And then Andy told me the next day, he's like, yeah, you hear about the massive forest fire in Volusia County? Like, it's like the smoke and stuff. It's like, messing with the light and the sun. I'm just like, thank God.
It's like 3,000 acres that are like right down the road that are just being burned in a controlled fire. Like, so it's like
there's like a reddish hue like everywhere. I'm just like,
is this a sign?
Josh is so paranoid.
Oh, man.
None of you guys are seeing this, right?
Oh, brother.
Losing my mind.
Dude, it freaked me out, though.
Oh, my gosh, man.
That's so funny.
Yeah, but the sun is real.
Confirmed.
Both of them. Both of them are real.
Well, they're doing like the same, like where they zoom in like with their video and like they do like screenshots of the sun and like the glares and there's like textiles to it.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's probably the camera, like the
pixels, the what?
Yeah, the lens or like chip or whatever sensors that are within the thing. It's like, it's not your eye that's seeing these pixels. It's you're taking a picture of it with an electronic thing and it looks like a computer chip.
Yeah. People who are suspicious about space, I just can't. I mean, space is the most real thing to me in the world.
Yo, space freaks me out.
I think that's what...
Space is nuts.
I think that's what centers me. Like, I think, like, knowing that exists, like, confirms that, okay, none of this real stuff is, like, any real big deal at all.
I laughed so hard.
It's so much bigger.
On the Dusty episode, when he was like, yeah, space isn't real.
Dude, that was 5 seconds into the episode, and I was like, this is immediately going to be so good.
That's so funny.
Dude, Dusty was funny every second, every word.
It was so funny.
Incredible just to be in front of a guy that's like that quick.
I just love that he actually, in his own time, without knowing he was ever going to be on a podcast like ours, researches the things that we talk about.
Yeah, I did not expect that at all.
What a guy.
What a burger.
What a burger.
What a burger.
Oh, but...
What about the biscuits?
No. What was the other day? It was... we were talking about the...
Yeah.
What was it?
Don't worry. You're not going to get me.
No.
Wait, you mean serious?
It was the thing with space.
The space thing.
We got to don't go anywhere!
Hey guys, we have some brand new colors here at Sunday Cool. We have the sage and tan. It's absolutely beautiful colors, the heather, and they're absolutely wonderful with our water-based ink, super soft ink on a super soft tee. It's incredible. If you go to sundaycool.com, you can order customizable merch for you, your group, your church, your organization, whomever.
Yep.
Danny, what do you say?
I say, domo oregato, misto robato.
Wow.
Is that... SendItCool.com.
Hey!
Whoa. What is that? Wow, you're really fast.
You're so fast.
You're really fast in those new socks.
Oh, these socks that you can buy at SendItCoolSwag.com?
Not those ones. We have the brand new special edition black socks.
Oh.
SendItCoolSwag.com.
That ad was fun.
I had a great time, and I can't believe Danny did that.
The whole robot dance?
The other thing, too, but I don't even want to say it.
Oh, yeah.
Because he did it. Yeah. It's like, ooh. Cool. You have to go back and watch the ad to know. Hopefully, he didn't skip it.
Yeah. Sorry. I shouldn't have made me feel
uncomfortable.
I shouldn't have.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
You're never leaving Danny.
Sorry. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave.
I was looking at the guitar, man.
I don't know what that is. The most
Hotel iconic California. Guitar solos of all time.
If you guys were singing Hotel California, that wasn't it.
It's the most famous line in Hotel California. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave.
You knew that.
I don't act like you know the song. You don't know.
We said the lyrics.
I don't listen to lyrics. That's actually like...
I listen to the vibe.
Stop it. It's one of the most famous lyrics of all time and one of the most iconic guitar solos of all time.
Respect it.
You should have known that.
Do you guys see this picture?
Yeah, we see it. What's up with that? That's weird.
I'm still mad about Hotel California.
These are called witches stairs.
Witches?
Witches.
Why?
Is this?
That's kind of weird. Okay.
So there's an account. It's called History is Cool on Instagram. They're dope. But this is what they said about it. These are called witches' stairs. It is believed that the design was thought to confuse or trap witches, preventing them from easily climbing the stairs due to the staggered pattern. Unlike traditional stairs with a regular series of steps, witches' stairs alternate, which each step offsets to either the left or right. The design creates a zigzag pattern, allowing for the steep incline without requiring a large horizontal space.
Just going to tell you right now.
So witches obviously can't.
Do not like this conversation.
We hear, as we hear people coming down the steps upstairs.
Oh, yeah.
Wait a minute.
You ain't got no witches stairs here.
I'll get you, my pretty.
Up those stairs, I will.
Oh, God.
Dude, that's like the myth. It's like the witches easily just look at the stairs and like, I'm just going to walk up these stairs. It's like when people say you have to like zigzag with alligators.
Yeah, I know. Oh, like, man, I got to think about
it. It's like, who told you that? The alligator? Because you can easily just come get you quicker. Like, that's not happening.
But witch or not, those stairs, I would definitely trip over.
Oh, for sure.
And then they would
100%.
Like, you're a witch.
It's a burner.
I'm like, these stairs are confusing,
man.
Do
you know how hard this is?
What is this?
Dude, I saw a TikTok the other day, and it was like teenagers back in like you know, like those like the Blair Witch Trial times, like those brand new to America, and it's like just how just bratty teenagers would have been, like just like pouting, like, Mom, can we not have pigs do this tonight? We've had it four times in a row. It's like, oh, sure would be a shame if everyone thought you were a witch. Just like start spreading rumors that your mom's a witch.
Dude, what a scary time though.
Dude, terrifying. It would be a nightmare.
You'd be considered a witch if you had a birthmark.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
The warts too and stuff. Like that's literally like where the witch's warts and stuff. If you had warts and stuff, like that's literally was a sign. I was like, that's insane.
They called birthmarks witches' marks.
Yeah.
Really?
Ooh.
Okay. Well.
Well.
All right.
Lily has a birthmark on her leg.
Witch.
Totally.
Yeah, and that's why she's not here tonight.
Yeah.
She's been burnt at the stake right now.
And she always thought, she never expressed it to anyone what she thought the birthmark looked like. A lot of people are like, oh, it looks like an ice cream cone.
Yeah.
And my brother is like, it looks like your birthmark's giving me the finger.
It looks like a middle finger?
Yeah. And she's like, I've always thought that and no one's ever said that.
That's Taylor. Crazy. Taylor, your brother?
So he's a witch too.
Wow.
Yeah.
A witch's, witch's connection.
That's hilarious. I don't think I've ever seen it. That's hilarious. We need to upload that on Patreon. Yeah. Just a picture of the birthmark on Patreon.
Yeah, just legs, so. Andy.
I stare at your legs. Golly. I look at the birthmarks.
I've stared at legs a lot. I don't think I've ever seen anything.
No, that's
like
interesting.
That.
Whenever I looked at the birthmark, I just saw a heart. What? Why would you say that?
Hey!
Wazy guy!
Hey!
Hey, what's going on?
Last time I was looking at Lily's legs, I didn't even notice that. Hey.
The heck you say? I know, right? It's hard to see. Wait a minute. Yeah, I know. That's wait a minute.
You have an alien question.
I have an alien question. I just can't. We came up with like on the way to the arena today.
It was a good question.
The idea is an alien mothership comes down with a whole army and they land in front of you and they're intimidating and they have weapons and you're scared, you're shaking, and the alien leader comes up to you, looks you in the eyes, and he asks you a question. He says, I need one song to convince me to not destroy your planet. And you have Spotify in your hands.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a saved person. If you're not, if you're a sinful person, then you would have Apple Music. Andrew. But you pull out your Spotify. What is the song you're picking?
I love that question.
To save humanity.
It's a great question. Jeez.
To save humanity, what are you doing? What's the song? Are you playing it?
I don't want to play it because I don't want to
sing it.
What's it called? Hold on. Does anyone have an answer?
If I leave here tomorrow. Leonard Skinner, baby, Free Bird.
Okay.
All right. What do you think?
Dude, honestly.
What do you think?
Because they would be like, they would immediately just be like, I don't know.
What is this?
And then like, what is the big line? And this bird you cannot change. They would literally have the guns up at that point. Like the laser beams would be heating up and you'd be like, no. And like, wait for the guitar solo.
Yeah.
And then suddenly they would be like, wait a minute. And they put it down and they would, everyone was singing harmony.
I mean,
I feel like it could work.
That's a good one.
I would say that's kind of like the cliche answer, but it's the correct answer.
For sure, the cliche answer.
Yeah. Because it's no matter. I would honestly, you want to hear it? If we get flagged, too bad. But I'll just play the first.
No, not too bad.
It's not on any streaming service technically right now. So
okay, safe.
Oh.
Royal Otis Lingers cover. Because I think that would just make them cry, and they would just be hugging.
A cover? The cover of Linger?
Yes. If you ever, guys have not heard that, I'm sure most of you have. Royal Otis Linger. Look it up on YouTube. It's incredible. Okay. And my girls have been singing it constantly. Yeah, that's great.
All right.
But I think just because I know that would just emotionally wreck them right in their face.
It's a great song.
Like, I need to call my mom.
It's a great song. I don't know that I've heard that cover. I gotta check it out.
Dude, I'll have to.
After this.
I gotta check it out. Okay.
Patreon.
We'll just have a video of it just jamming
we
out
can
to
do,
it.
We can do all the music.
We can do whatever on Patreon. Yeah, okay.
Anything goes.
Do you have a song?
Yeah, I don't think it would save the world, but it would fire me up to fight back.
Just to die in a blaze of glory.
Yeah. A Demolisher by Slaughter to Prevail. For all the metalheads out there, you know it.
But okay, I'll have to listen to that.
You said a lot scary. Of fierce words right there. Say it again.
It's a Russian metal guy who was kicked out of Russia for being accused of being a Satanist, which he denies up and down. He just said he likes violent language. And so, yeah, it's a...
Don't we all, though?
Yeah. I'm not a Satanist. I just... like, wow,
it's actually kind of funny. He he's adamantly opposed to the war against Ukraine.
Okay.
And he's like, I know that our songs are all about violence, but violence is never the answer. And it's just comical to say that at a show where every other lyric is about violent things.
Oh, wow, okay.
But
yeah.
What do you pick?
I just thought of it now.
Hit me.
Go.
It's called The Plagues from Prince of Egypt.
Oh, really? Okay.
And it's intense.
What's your motive behind it? Do you think that they're going to enjoy it?
No, they're going to be like, they're going to be like.
Insulted?
No, they're going to be like, yo, God can do this?
Yeah.
We out.
We gone.
Out of here.
Toodles.
It's like, I send the plagues. I send the thus saith the Lord. And they're like,
ah!
Go.
We have to get out of here.
Abort.
We'll play it on Patreon because it's literally, it has a.
That's what we'll do on half episode. We'll play all of our songs.
Yeah, Voldemort.
Yeah. There we go.
Good idea.
Yeah. So Voldemort, he sings the duet part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So what's his name?
Who?
The actor.
Yeah, the actor who plays Voldemort.
Oh, Ralph Fiennes? But Fiennes or... Yeah, Ralph Fiennes. How funny would it be if, like, we're all just standing as humanity and then, like, one guy gets selected to do the song and we're all, like, collectively, like, billions of people just sitting around and we're just, like, seeing him scroll through Spotify and you're like, why is he scrolling past the bees? Why aren't the Beatles leaning? Like, you know, everyone's, like, wondering what song and it's, like, playing through the biggest speakers in the world and then suddenly it's just silence. He hits play and it's just silence and it just goes... I'm through with standing in line.
Just kill them.
I just think that would be, if I have to go out, I hope I'm going out laughing like that. Something like in a hilarious instance. Yeah.
My second choice would be a Bohemian Rhapsody.
I thought about that one, actually.
Yeah, that would be a classic.
So confused.
Also, even if they didn't like it, at least you get like 5 minutes of pure enjoyment.
Yeah.
And the whole, the whole world
like
would be
eight
singing
minutes,
it.
Though, isn't it?
This song is changing so much. I don't know what to do.
Did you change a song? This is a different melody.
We only gave you one song. Now you've played eight songs for us. Die.
Why is everyone headbanging?
What is a second bridge?
Oh. Yeah.
Thanks for laughing, Danny.
Sorry. That was good, actually.
Hey, good times, y'all.
Hey, good times, good questions. That was Question Corners with Andy. Because it's better.
Do you have something?
I have a question, and it feels weird now that he said he did Question Corner with Andy, so this is Question Corner with Andrew. No. That's for Lily.
Question corner.
How would you do it? Like a Hawaiian style?
Oh, jeez.
Andrew has a question
for us. Terrible.
All right, so let's start out. When you think of Southern food, what comes to mind?
Fried chicken.
Okay. Keep throwing out like
mac and cheese,
collard greens,
mac and cheese,
fried okra, baked beans,
barbecue,
biscuits.
Like, I think of like some good smoked barbecue and stuff like that.
Smoked ribs.
Yeah. When you think of Northern cuisine, what do you think of?
No clue.
Fish.
Yeah, like
communism.
Like a lot of like
depression,
king crab.
I don't know. What do communists eat?
Smog.
I don't
know. Liberal. Whoa.
Grit.
Yuppies. I don't know.
Everybody's rude. I don't know what you're talking about.
No one says hi. Okay, what? We can't wave anymore? What is it, a crime? Okay, I don't know. Food in the North.
Pizza.
But yeah, like, I mean, you think New York, a lot of like European immigrant food, like a lot of British food.
Yes.
So the question is, would you rather live in the South forever eating only Northern food or live in the North forever only eating Southern food?
I can live in the South and I. Nothing against the North. I've lived in the North. I was born in the North, but I would rather live in the South.
It's about the people.
You can feel it.
Good question, though.
I'm just realizing I care way more about
no
food
matter how
than
you
the
answer,
rest
you're
of you two.
You're going to offend half the nation.
That was the goal.
50-50.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like you can make
the Midwest.
If you're a good cook, you can make good food out of it.
No one says that.
You need both.
That's
foods.
True, actually.
No one says that.
Stop.
What is the Midwest? We asked that question kind of, or Andy, you did on the Dusty episode.
Yeah, I don't know where it starts and ends, but.
Yeah. Like the South.
I mean, Missouri is definitely like the center of the Midwest, or the like. I mean, I don't know.
You were Missouri, Kansas?
I mean, that was definitely I know Missouri's Midwest, but I don't know anything beyond that.
Chicago.
There's a lot beyond that. There's a lot of states, a lot of cities.
We
a
live a lot of
cities.
There's a lot of cities.
Is that what you just said? Like
there's a lot of states. There's a lot of cities. I don't know.
There's a lot of cities. There's a lot of people out there.
What are you doing?
I'm checking out where the Midwest is.
Why are you poking fun at me?
I'm just poking fun.
My voice cracked. I'm tired.
Okay, get over it.
It's late.
I'm over it, but you dove into it.
You don't seem like you're over it.
I'm gonna fight you.
I'm gonna strangle you.
I'm gonna kill you.
Oh, okay. Where is the Midwest?
What a Google search. Sorry, everybody. Joining us from these states, we don't know where you are.
So Iowa, Illinois, and Indiana are like the main ones, apparently.
The main ones?
It just doesn't seem like the middle. Isn't Midwest supposed to? I guess it's in the middle of the West? Or what does that mean?
That's what I'm saying.
Well, then how far west is it? Like, does it get to Colorado when it's now the West?
I mean, look at that. That doesn't look like the right map for Midwest. It looks like Mideast.
And just straight up mid north.
Iowa. So they're saying South Dakota and North Dakota.
What are you laughing at?
I have something completely.
We don't know what's happening.
Now look at that. They say that's the Midwest. That's crazy.
No.
That's literally just north, mid north. I don't know what that means.
So here's the takeaway. All of our confusion and not being able to answer that is completely justified because none of those maps make sense.
Okay. Midwest is Minnesota, Iowa, Missouri, Illinois, Wisconsin, Michigan, Indiana, Ohio.
Minnesota.
That's crazy. Or in South Dakota, North Dakota, and Minnesota, apparently. I don't know.
Is this just because we live in Florida? This is why we're so confused? Is that what's happening?
It's possible.
It's just hard to break it up. What do you got?
I want to laugh.
I was talking to Lily today about the podcast.
Okay.
Of like topics to talk about.
Okay.
And she said, you should talk about how dinosaurs look different than we think on tonight's pod. I said, what do you mean?
What?
And she sent me a TikTok. And then I watched it, and then she said, "So the TikTok was basically like what we."
These are the dumbest. Oh my gosh! Sorry, golly, I am so sorry. I apologize. My volume was way up. Song segment, and I apologize. Continue. Keep going, please.
So rude.
I'm sorry.
What I was saying, Andy, this TikTok was basically saying like we have these skeletons of dinosaurs in museums, And then they shape the dinosaurs of like what they looked like. But she's like, if you think about it, like that's like if we're to have a skeleton like ourselves, like our nose, right? Mm-hmm. So like skulls, there's no nose. It's like all cartilage,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So like, what does that mean for like dinosaurs and like all these fossils they're finding? And she showed a like an example of like a skeleton. And it's like, okay, we take this skeleton. It was like this little animal. It's like, what would it look like if you were to shape it like how they do dinosaurs? And it looked like a little velociraptor. She's like, actually, it's a rabbit. And it was a rabbit skeleton.
Oh, so they manipulated the bones to make it look like a velociraptor.
No, they're basically giving the example of like...
Like, but they took the bones of a rabbit and like, if we change these bones around, we can manipulate it to make it look like...
Not even change the bones around. It was just like add skin to it.
And got mm-hmm. it. Okay. Because
of like the features of the skeleton itself.
So not even just the plain skeleton of the rabbit itself originally. So
it's just like basically just putting skin on it.
Wow.
And so that's like... Her argument was like, that's like what we've done with all these fossils.
There's another incident where that happened. They what they did is they presented to like a group. I don't know what the scientific term for people who deal with dinosaur bones is, but whatever those people are.
Paleontologists.
Paleontologists. So they gave them these remains and they said, this is a dinosaur we found. Please assemble it. And they did it. It looked also like a little raptor of some sort. And what it was straight up canine. It was like a modern canine, and they told him it was old.
That's really interesting. This whole thing is actually really interesting because Jurassic Park is, like that.
But then she continued, and she said, "And then you should have everyone speculate on how scientists would have drawn Andy based on his fossils."
That's good.
And then. She said, and have your drawing prepared and make it look like someone from my 600-pound life.
Oh, my God.
Lily, she's off the rails.
What is her deal? What is her deal?
You're like the only one who did anything for your health this week, too. Like you actually woke up and went running the other day.
This is insane.
This is hysterical.
Whew. Golly, dude. That's ridiculous.
From the top row.
You have your drawing prepared?
Jeez. No.
That's hysterical.
That was so funny. Just reading the text was the segment. Yeah. Just like, because she wanted us to be like talking about this like all serious and like...
Also,
like for me to bring up, like, well, what would Andy's skeleton look like if, like, we were to excavate it and like find it, like, how would you make it? Like, actually, here's a drawing. That was her whole bit, and it was really good.
That's so good.
That is pretty good.
That's really funny.
So
gosh,
dumb.
Man. Oh, really?
Do the David Attenborough.
This creature. Born without a father, lost in the wilderness, a world traveler, eating everything in sight.
Oh, man.
The bearded man,
who was quite balding, but luckily has found a mate 11 years ago, before it ever happened, before he gained the weight and lost the hair. His mate certainly must regret it.
Yeah, so.
That's great. I love that. Have you seen that TikTok trend of daughters or kids just asking their New Jersey dads?
Mike Wazowski.
If they know Mike Wazowski. Yeah. That's amazing. They're like, you know Mike Wazowski?
Yeah, Dad, like, you know Mike Wazowski from high school?
He's like, Mike Wazowski? What do you think? Yeah, I know Mike Wazowski. He used to work at the club down at down the street. The New York, he's like, really? Like, they just instantly, all the kids start cracking up. And it's not just one dad. It's almost every single dad.
It's so
like,
good.
That's you great. Know Mike Wazowski? Yeah, I used to go to school with him.
Yeah, I know Mike Wazowski. Are we kidding?
Yeah, he passed away last year. What's up? Went to his funeral.
He's a great friend.
Yeah, but his godfather. What are you talking about?
From elementary. What are you talking about? Great school.
Great guy.
His dad, he had the, mom, the.
He played for the Niners.
Yeah, the Niners. He,
But his grandpa,
Jerry Wazowski.
His grandpa was a shoe shiner down the end.
Yeah, there's.
Oh, I know Kozowski.
Yeah, he sold me my first car. It's so funny.
Oh man.
Well, I have. Do you want a dark thing?
Should we shave it? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, sure.
Shave it or save it?
Shut up, dude. You and your wife are the exact same. I hate it.
Hey,
hey, take it back.
Don't look at her legs.
Get your eyes off that birthmark.
Eyes up, Andy.
Yeah, I guess I'll save it.
I mean, we already.
It's very deep.
Yeah, we already got. This is a good podcast already.
Is it?
Yeah, it's an hour and 20. We're already.
Jeez.
It's an hour and 2. Hours.
Oh, or two. It's upside down.
Golly,
it didn't compute.
It's an hour dyslexic.
This Andy character can only read things upside down.
Confused easily by simple numbers.
After Lily's description of what he might have looked like, I'm picturing the chick in Nacho Libre going through tunnels, but Andy crawling through the jungle with David Attenborough commentating on it.
Just every time I wake up in the
fruit tree.
Middle of the night, just going through the cupboard.
As he scurries for his late night snack.
We need a creature. Don't tell Lily. Tell her to draw that version of me.
Okay.
And no one else will do it. We'll just shame her.
We'll do that.
Perfect.
We'll show it in this podcast.
Yeah, that's so like when you get home.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
That's really good.
Have your drawing prepared.
Yeah. We gotta talk about like one more thing though.
One more thing.
Should I tell my ghost story?
Yes.
Ooh,
you have a ghost story?
Yes, he has a ghost story. He told us last night.
Oh man. Well, we talked about it today. Yesterday.
Yeah. Last night.
Last night. Yeah.
I don't even know how that came up, but this is like a really funny family story. But the more I think about it, the more I get like kind of like creeped out.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So the deal is that this was when I was like 20 or 21 years old. I don't know. This is a while ago.
It's like 20 years ago.
30, give or take.
Easy. I write
easy.
Checks. Easy. So basically, my grandmother had passed away like 6 to 8 months or so, I think, before this time. And Courtney and I were still dating, or we were engaged at the time, and I had left her house and driven back to my house. It was summer break from college, and I went back to my house, and my family was like out of town or something. I went home, and it was back in the days of like the answering machines. Okay, so you know, like it's flashing.
What's that?
Yeah, I know. Seriously,
so what's that, Dad?
Back in my day. So you're like, flashing red. You have a new message, right? So on my bedside table, there's a phone and answering machine's flashing around. I'm like, oh, cool. There's a new message. Like, well, this is kind of weird. Like, what's this from? So, okay. Grandmother has been dead a while.
Yeah.
Right? And let me set the context a little bit more. She was very needy of my dad. And so she would call my dad all the time. She loved Alabama football. Okay. Roll Tide. So that's part of the story. So she would always call and wonder like what channel is Alabama playing on, that kind of thing. So I'm like, okay, cool. New message. Thinking like maybe Courtney called me while I was on the drive home or something like that. And
you certainly weren't thinking anything else like that.
Not even close. So I hit play and I'm just like kind of whatever, getting ready to go to bed, hit play. And it's my grandmother. And she's like, my dad's name is Fred, and she calls him Freddie. She's like, Freddie, I'm just calling to see. She's from Tennessee. Just calling to see what channel Alabama's playing on tonight. Just wanted. So, and I'm just like.
Yeah, what are you feeling? What is your reaction?
What is happening right now?
How did that make you feel?
Why is she on the answering machine? She's dead. Like, what is going on? Why wasn't this flashing a year ago? Mm-hmm. What's happening? And so I'm just like it's still in my bedroom, just like panicked. And then she ends the message. Like I cannot move. She ends the message by saying like, she's calling about what channel the Alabama's playing on. And she goes, Roll Tide. I'll be watching. Click. Bro.
How long has she been deceased.
Like 6 to 8 months. I don't know the exact time because it's kind of like.
And so it was blinking. Like
it was blinking new.
Was it
like
during,
a new message?
Was it actually during football season too?
It was after football season.
So it wasn't. Yeah. So it was just an out of.
Yeah. Like, it was like. So this would have been summer break. So it's in the summer.
Yeah. That's so scary, dude.
Weird, dude.
Did you call Courtney?
I immediately called Courtney on her house phone, and I was like freaking. I'm like, Granny is haunting me. What's going on? I'm terrified, and I couldn't sleep that whole night. And
it like, tells you what time and the date and everything before, right?
Like, well, no, on this, it's just like one new message. Like one is on like the digital screen, and then the red like lights flashing.
The answering machines. It's like
usually it says like what time,
the day, like. When they call in.
Yeah. New message.
Yeah, it's not like it's like a
whatever
glitch. It's like it has to be like a landline to
right.
a landline.
Exactly.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. And so over
and
the last
weird.
Right. And so over the last like 20 whatever year, if I hadn't been like, I don't know, 15 years I think it's been. So over the last years it's been like a joke, like a family joke, and we're always like joke back and forth, you're like, roll tide, I'll be watching. But like when you actually think about this, it's terrifying.
It's dark a little bit.
It's terrifying.
That is super scary. I don't know how I would feel. That would be like, especially like, because that's the last thing you're thinking that you're going to hear. That's the last voice you hear because you haven't heard that voice in how long. And so it's like, so to like, just be like sitting there and I imagine you're not even looking at the voice because you just hit play and you're doing your own thing. And then suddenly you just hear the voice. Like that would, I'm scared myself just thinking about it. Like that would be nuts.
Yeah. Never really got over that one.
No, what's more terrifying than that? That's the fact that she was an Alabama fan. That's the really scary thing, man. That people could support an organization like that.
That hard.
Roll Tide.
R.I.P. Nick Saban.
Roll Tide.
Tide the detergent.
Tide the detergent.
Cleans.
Cleans.
Washes away. God used to wash away evil spirits.
Still does. I think he still does.
I mean, Jesus, like, on earth. Yeah.
Okay.
Evil spirits.
Evil spirits. Gen Z at 1.8 Tide Pods.
And it went viral.
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 Infectious sickness.
Infectious disease.
Can lead to death.
Death.
Grandma.
Died.
Unfortunately.
Died.
Ghosts.
Ghosts.
What is
guys,
happening?
Everything is connecting. It's scary. I'm really scared for our own protection right now.
We cracked the code. Oh, man.
So the Watchers.
I'll be watching.
No, we shouldn't get into the Watchers. Okay. It's literally...
It's
midnight right now.
It is midnight.
Should we film the half episode tomorrow or tonight?
No, we got to do it tonight.
Okay. All right. Well, I guess they're going to have to go to patreon.com/ninjas or butterflies to go see it then.
Hey,
go now. Go to SundayCoolSwag.com to get your merch because that's where all the Ninja and Cool Carl and Sunday Cool Tees merch is at, baby.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And you're going to watch on Patreon me and Andrew wrestle
and kiss.
Yep. Hold
hands.
We're
not going to tell which one happens first.
Who kisses who if who wins?
You do. You do.
All right, guys. Love you.
Love you guys. Doo-doo. Hey, put up your heart. Thank you.
Love y'all.
Love you guys.
Bye-bye.
See you.
Ninja.
Bye.
Go.
Did I say ninja? I meant
butterfly.
The butterfly is no doubt one of God's most beautiful creatures.
Has an empty your mind.
You were martial arts.
Ninjas are dead.
Oh, wait. Make sure to review us.
Yeah, don't forget about that.
5 stars.
And this is probably after the ad thing. And probably the outro. And
they
may not even hear this. So, I mean, we could say whatever we want.
Yeah, we could say that.
Yeah.
Right?
We could say.
Hey, wait.
Whoa.
You can't say that.
I just did.
I guess he did.
I guess he did.